Wow, what's going on, guys? We are back again for another Deus Ex Mankind Divided. Now, the nice thing is we're going to be doing Koller's mission, and we're going to be augmenting ourselves again with the calibrator, making our bodies even better and more extravagant. Now, the last mission we did, Forks in the Road, Jensen's meeting with Janice didn't go as planned. The hacker divided Bob Page, CEO of First Life, as the third NSN conspirator and was urging Jensen to break into a First Life vault when security drones arrived, forcing Jensen to flee. He'd barely escaped the ambush when a frantic nomad, Stanek, got in touch with him. The watchmaker had discovered that his daughter's life was in jeopardy. Jensen needed to come now to save her. Before he could, though, Vega called in. First Life was moving crucial evidence out of Prague's property bank tonight. Jensen needed to acquire it before that happened, but unfortunately he couldn't do both missions. Now, if you didn't see the last episode, I highly recommend it because a lot of stuff went down. I'm talking like that mission, I had to choose bank or Stanek's daughter, and I chose, well, you're gonna have to find out. But in the last episode, when you see it, there's a huge twist, which I want to talk about, but I can't, because if you didn't see the last episode, you just can't. But I'm going to give you this right here. Right now, pause the video. If you pause the video right now, I won't give you any spoilers. Ready? Alright. Now, if you are still listening, go back and watch the last episode. I probably should have told you that before you paused the video. But, you know, it's whatever. So I'm going to be talking about what happened in the last episode. If you don't mind, I'm about to say it. Alright. So basically, in the last episode, I chose to go for Stanek's daughter. I chose life. I said, I can't just give her up. When I got there, a strange twist happened. She was in a cult. So she didn't seem as normal state of mind as Stanek may have wanted her to be. So when I went there, I had the choice of being able to save her. Well, that mission, basically, I did everything wrong. I didn't save her at all, and I also didn't get the orchid information. So literally that mission, the one you're looking at right now, complete failure in all ways. We did finish off doing this mission right here. It's another side mission. Optional is investigating the scene. So that's what I'm going to do now, and the next one would be traveling to there. EMP fragment.
Just because Monte trusts Clifford doesn't mean I
feel like there's stuff underneath. ID card. Ooh. Broken glass. Oh, broken glasses.
I think he found something.
And there's a studio bag. Away from but crime, all it says is grab. Sir. Yeah. There's seven evidence. Jeez. There's a vent up there, but I don't know how necessary it is.
They love the stairs apart.
There's cones, a pizza box. This might have been where a guy might have been sleeping, just like a hobo or something. Now it looks to be that this doesn't show me much of anything. My vision.
Away from the crimes.
Her marks. Bruises on her neck. A needle. Interesting. I got 6 out of 7, so I have one more piece of evidence that I could find.
Thought as much.
My question is, what is it? I'm thinking it's gotta be something like up here. There is a vent, but I can't really access it without getting on top of that arc. You know, other stuff, other climbing things, but I doubt they would put evidence like that unless it was a little bit more easily accessible. Oh, there's gotta be like something else.
These assholes try anything.
Can't find anything.
You're joking, right?
Is there any way to get up? Just an upward motion. Like stairs, roofs, something.
What?
wasn't for Johnny, then I might have pegged you for this.
What? What did I do?
I have some questions for you.
I will cooperate. You have promised to help, and so I will try to help as well.
How did the attack happen? What was the killer doing?
He was on top of her. Cutting the evil out. That's what he called it. I think.
So you heard his voice?
Very clearly, yes. He sounded confident, authoritarian, like a general commanding troops.
What did he say exactly?
It is time to make you whole again.
What were you doing here?
I was looking for Starlight, my cat. There was lightning and suddenly this flash of certainty. That's when I knew something awful was happening.
Where were you exactly?
In the shadows. My head was down. I couldn't move. Oh God, stupid Daria. I shouldn't have gone out today. The energies were all wrong.
Can you remember anything about what the killer looks like?
To be honest, I saw more of the shadow than the man. I remember he was very big. The shadow, it covered everything.
So you can't describe him?
Not the face, no. His clothes, he was wearing something very dark. Black, maybe blue.
Was he augmented?
He moved like an augmented man, but I can't say for sure.
Is there anything else I should know about you?
You want to know about Daria? What is there to tell? Small town girl came to the big city to escape her problems, to try and become someone else.
Did it work?
Not really. You can't escape yourself. You can't just come to a big city and expect all your problems to seem smaller. It doesn't work that way.
Why is it you don't trust the police to take care of this case?
I have bad memories of the police.
What kind of memories?
Get calls I didn't want. Tickets I didn't deserve. The policemen here are worse than children. Former captains of high school sports teams who'll never recapture their years of glory.
I was captain of the debate team in high school.
Yes, well, debate is different.
What's your take on Montag? You ever meet him before tonight?
I went to the station once, years ago, to complain about the ticket. Detective Montag is the one they send you to handle the paperwork.
How'd he do?
He did fine. The point is, he's a desk jockey. Look at him, he's lost out here. The cops who know how to catch killers, they're not the ones sent to investigate murdered ox.
I'm gonna do what I can to help the investigation.
Good luck.
There's one more piece of evidence that I might need, and I can't find it. You guys probably like screaming at the screen going, it's right there! You can't miss it!
Maybe tomorrow.
The line goes all the way out to here. My thing is, I don't think anything is out here. My augmented eyes doesn't say anything. Like I said, I think that vent is the best option to do, and I have no idea how to get up there.
The news just keeps getting worse.
It's a bar. I'm gonna see if I can try and find a way up. Up some stairs, something. I should find like a ventilation system. And if I can find a ventilation system, maybe that and lead to the spot on the wall. I've been to here before, I think. That's just the downstairs. If this is a restricted area, yeah, it's not necessary. Not yet. I'll do it later. But for right now, I think that's it. I don't think there's a vent around this spot, though. So let's go around, go back down to where we were, and see what we can do from there. Because I don't see why they would put, like, anything up there. It's too far away. I don't understand it. Why can't I find that piece of evidence? There's one more evidence. One more thing. Is it on her? I wouldn't be surprised.
Ow.
There was a needle, her marks.
Giving you updates every few minutes.
Bruises. I have no idea where I'm looking. What the heck? This is starting to, like, get a little annoying.
Yeah, I thought as much.
Enjoying yourself, detective.
Alright, I have some questions about the murder.
Before we go any further with this, I need you to know something about Johnny Gunn. He's not a good man. I may not like how my bosses are targeting him, but that doesn't mean he's innocent. So, you know, just make sure you're here for the right reasons.
Why else would I be here?
I don't want this to turn into some kind of crusade. Bad men do bad things. In a perfect world, we arrest them for the right reasons, but, well, the world's not always perfect.
You'll only arrest the victim's husband if the evidence tells you to, right? It's not enough that he's an hog, and that your bosses want him to go down.
I'll hold my guys off for as long as I can. But unless you can prove someone else killed Angela, or at the very least that Johnny didn't, I don't have much choice. That's why I'm trusting you to talk to him. Give me your honest opinion on what happened here.
Yeah. Why are you trusting me exactly?
Because you gave me the impression of being qualified. Because I'm big enough to admit that maybe I can use the help, and between you and me, because the thought of confronting a man like Johnny Gunn scares the shit out of me.
How long have you been a cop?
Too long. And of all the ways to go out, eh?
What do you mean?
I mean being assigned a case like this. It's HQ's little joke before sending me off to retirement. Oh, but don't worry about me, eh? I'm a survivor. I can make it through this.
This case is a joke to you?
I didn't say that. I said it's a joke to HQ. They know I haven't left my desk in years. But that doesn't mean I'm not qualified. Just a little rusty.
People hold a hell of a grudge against hogs, ever since the incident.
Yes, and?
Well, good thing the cops here are such professionals. Part of being a police officer is treating everyone the same, right? Hog or no hog.
It's not that simple, and you know it. A police force isn't some abstract ideal of what justice and law should be. It's an instrument of those in power. A reflection of the society it protects.
I haven't been seeing a whole lot of protection out there.
Well, that depends who you ask.
I'm here because I don't like the idea of someone killing people right outside my window. Maybe he's out there right now, targeting that poor witness. Maybe he's just looking for any chance to do it again.
Fair enough, Mr. Interpol.
Do you know if the victim had any enemies?
I know she and Johnny didn't get along. Other than that, I really couldn't tell you.
Tell me about the victim's husband, Johnny.
He used to work for a private military company, Bell Tower. He's been arrested for all sorts of things in the past. Now, don't get me wrong. I believe in evidence. But I also believe in playing the odds. 9 times out of 10, the husband did it.
Why are your superiors so eager to pin Johnny for murder? It's gotta be more than just not liking the guy.
Standard policy for guys like Johnny. The way they see it, you send a man like him into Golem City, and he's liable to go off the grid, end up with Arc or God knows who. he becomes 10 times more trouble than he's worth. But if they can charge him with something big, something like murder, well, suddenly he's no trouble at all.
Interesting.
I spoke to Daria. She's able to confirm that the suspect is male. Other than that, she's all over the place. I think she's pretty shaken up.
Yeah, well, can't blame her. I would be too. You seem to have made a good impression, though. Ever since you got here, she seems different, calmer. You know, I met my first wife over a crime scene. Let me give you a very important piece of advice, eh? Never marry the ones you save.
Did the killer leave anything behind? Does anything strike you as odd?
I don't know. It's a murder, you know? Doesn't matter if you look at it sideways or upside down. It's never going to look normal.
I found a broken needle stuck in the victim's shoulder. The killer might have drugged Angela before killing her.
Maybe. But keep in mind, she was an og. Don't you all have to shoot up that new pulse shit? Let's go for the obvious before jumping to any wild conclusions.
I'm assuming you know her augments were harvested. The marks on her body make it seem like the killer knew exactly what he was doing, knew exactly what he wanted.
The way you said that just now.
What about it?
The way you described the aug removal. And before, you mentioned a broken needle in the right shoulder?
That's right.
It reminds me, you know. There was this cop, Smolinski. He used to work in this neighborhood. He had this theory about a copycat. Someone acting just like a dead killer named, Svobodka.
You think there's a connection to another case?
I don't know yet. But I remember him mentioning something about needles and aug removal. Smolinski died in the police station bombing. Whatever files he had would have been moved into temp storage across the street from the bombed out station. Who knows? Maybe it's nothing.
I found a print on Angela's neck, next to the contusion marks. It's a partial, so I don't think we can match it to anything. But at least we know the killer left something, and that she was strangled.
Huh. A fingerprint. I must have missed that one. This is exactly the kind of evidence I'm talking about. No way Johnny could squirm his way out of something like that. If only we could link it to him.
Anything I should know about the scene? Anything jump out at you?
The dismembered body jumps out at me. Keep in mind, I've been behind a desk for the last 12 years. It all jumps out at me.
I found what looks like a grenade fragment. EMP by the looks of it. Killer might have used this to incapacitate her.
Interesting. Johnny wouldn't need an EMP to take down his wife. Riot police use EMPs to re-establish public order around here. With all the aug riots, anti-aug riots, it wouldn't surprise me if that's all it was. Still, interesting.
I found this piece of glass near the body. A pair of broken glasses, maybe?
I don't know what to tell you. We're in the back alley of a major city. There's bound to be broken glass.
I found this press ID on the victim.
Okay, enlighten me. We care about this... why?
Angela Gunn was a journalist. Maybe this is work-related. Maybe she uncovered something she wasn't supposed to.
Maybe. I don't know.
Not much help.
I want to help you with this case. To do that, I need a rundown of what you know already.
Help me, huh? You mean, like being my subordinate?
I mean like making sure we catch whoever's responsible.
Right. Well, I have a dead body, Angela Gunn. I have bureaucratic pressure to arrest the augmented husband, Johnny Gunn. I have a crime scene, and I have you.
I have what I need for now. I should go.
You do whatever you have to.
So now I still need to find this evidence and then travel to Sista Sjitrver. I don't know how to pronounce any of these words, but here's all the different evidence. The only thing I can think of is maybe, like I said, there's evidence up there. Not on the roof, that's impossible. I don't think I can even get to the roof. But I'm thinking up there. Where does this building lead to? Let me see if I can go around, see if there's anything on the other side of this building. Maybe I can find a way to get up there to the vents. Hopefully. A lot of tech here. Oh yeah, this is this building. I wonder if I can find anything here. It might be just me doing something for exploring, but I feel like there might be a way to get up to that vent up by the investigation area.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated. Access granted.
Here's a vent. And that looks to be everything in here. Ooh, triangle. Yep. So let's see what I can get to from this vent. I'm hoping this leads to where I'm supposed to be going. It leads here. What the heck is this? Oh, this is just this stairwell. I don't think I can find anything.
To be a violation of our rights.
There's a ladder here. No, it's a wall. It's not a ladder. I don't think there's any way of me doing anything right now. This is weird.
Hello.
So that means the evidence must be, you know, reachable. I don't think that there's a vent up there and it leads to something. That's what's irritating me.
Could be right around the corner.
That vent leads to something and it's it can bring me up there. Because if it's up there, if there's any evidence up there, it's gotta mean something. I have no idea what is going on with that evidence, but you know what? Before I finish this up, I'm gonna go see Koller. And Koller is gonna make me awesome.
Well, that is.
But I basically took up half the video trying to finish up that mission, and I'm gonna finish it up in the next episode. Possibly. Unless I have time to do it in this episode and I magically find out something. Hopefully. But, I doubt it. I didn't mean to fall down. But, it happens. Wow, I actually had like no health left. Not very good. Alright, let's let this heal up. And then we can go to Koller. See what I can get from there. Alright, what do you want, Koller? Oh, here he is.
Things with Otar aren't going so well, Jensen.
Sorry about your place, Koller. Are you alright?
Physically, yes. Emotionally, I just kinda... You know, I actually had some real good books up there. The bookstore was kind of a front, sure, but it was my front. The version of me I presented to the world. That means something.
It means whatever deal you thought you had with the Diwalis is apparently off.
My deal. Right.
There's something you're not telling me about why Otar's got it in for you.
Maybe he is just angry, you know? He takes it out on me because... because I'm prettier than he is. Or maybe he just really doesn't like books. It's possible, right? Look, let's just optimize that rig of yours, huh? You got the neuroplasticity calibrator for me or what?
I know you may not want to talk about what happened to your storm.
I get where you're coming from, okay? But try to understand, Jensen. I'm a guy who likes to respect privacy. Especially if the other person is someone who can kill me. Which is real good for you, actually. It goes both ways.
You're willing to ignore what happened?
I am trying to protect myself. Maybe next time, they don't just burn the store, huh?
I rely on you, Koller. And I'm willing to help if I can. I don't want to have to identify your remains next time I come in for a tune-up.
Neither of us want that. But sometimes, it's better to sweep the ashes under the rug. Now come on. Let's optimize that rig of yours.
One more question.
This procedure. There won't be any surprises like last time.
Last time I was surprised by your crazy tech. But now is totally different. Now I know what's under that hood of yours. And you got me the tool I need. Changes everything.
So what are you gonna do exactly?
I'm gonna optimize your system. No more worrying about overheating. No more worrying about glitches. Jensen 2.0. Sounds pretty good, right?
You can't hide forever. What are you gonna do when Otar comes back?
What do you expect from me? I am tangled up with these people now. This is what I get for saying yes to Radich. But what choice did I have? What choice do I have now?
Your choice is to tell me what the hell is going on. What does Otar want from you?
He wants to know what I know about Radich. That Radich needs me. The way you need me, Jensen. You understand?
Radich is augmented.
The head of the Diwali man. If Otar finds this out, if any of the Diwali finds this out, they are not very open-minded about these things.
Yeah, I get it, Koller. So what are you gonna do?
When augmented people ask for help, I help them. I continue to help Radich.
Wow.
All right.
Got an answer I didn't think I was going to get.
Neuroplasticity calibrator looks like.
That's the one! Okay, this won't take long, I promise. And don't worry, man, I never screw up two in a row. Spent a lot of time prepping for this one.
Just try not to take anything.
Here we go. Let's see what happens.
That wasn't so bad, right? How do you
okay.
feel?
I feel fine. I feel lighter.
I fixed you. Death to all your limits. Whatever implant you want to activate, you activate. Zero consequences.
That sounds pretty good. Thanks, Koller. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Just get out there and make me proud. Go make use of all that cool shit.
Well, there we go. So now I can have everything activated at once. That's pretty cool. Completionist. You are right, I am. I didn't read any of his emails. No, not at all. Boom. Gyroscope of regulator, stem processor. I still don't know what these are. Crafting parts are always useful. And let's just look around, make sure I can't pick anything up. Because, you know, I do like to explore Everything always gets used. Everything is always nice to have. And there we go. So now, out of missions, that's it. Alright, so now it's still find some evidence is the next part. Well, I can't believe that mission was literally just that, and that was it. And now we can just leave. And so now if I get any proxy upgrades, I can just upgrade everything. That's nice. Interesting. Well, I got a pocket secretary just in case. Just in case it gives me any information or anything I might need to use. Now, right now, I don't have any differences. I'm basically the exact same right now. Alright. Back to this thing.
Excuse me. Please, did they send you to protect me?
We already talked.
Excuse me. Please, did they send you to protect me?
I'm thinking, if I can find that vent, I can do something about it.
I need your help.
So that would mean going around. Oh, there's nothing. The best case would be that manhole or the merchant. Wonder where this manhole leads. See what it can give me. Didn't I come up from here, though? I might have.
Appearing before.
I think I did. I'm pretty sure I did. Like 99% sure.
I don't understand.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna take this back up. I don't think, because the manhole was already uncovered. And I'm pretty sure this was from the mission where the drones were messing around. And then I came out and then I saw that. And that was when I was like, oh wait, something happened. So the next thing would be go here. And there's a merchant.
Something wrong?
Is this it? It says this is it. Ebooks. I like to do this just because it's free experience and it might give me information. You never know.
Yes.
Newspaper, but that's locked.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Oh man, I don't think I'm gonna be able to reach that. I should be able to.
Access granted.
Perfect. Now this should get me something. There's no way I did all this to get to a secret room and have nothing. The door's locked. Great. Door locked, meaning there's a terminal. I don't know what this means. How do I unlock the door? Well, there's nothing there. Here it is. Are you serious? Get out my way. What? And I can't move it because my arms aren't strong enough yet. Do I have any proxies? No. Of course not. I only need a little bit more to get it, though. Dang it. So what can I do? I'm so confused. I really want to get this mission left. Or this mission done. This is the closest thing. This is it. For right now, there's no way to get up there.
Not do that again, Hunter.
I can see the ventilation, though. Kind of.
You think I don't know what's going on here?
Structural weakness. Oh my gosh. What are they searching for? What happened? I don't think they're searching for me. They can't be. And now he's glitching out a giant trash can. I mean, I'm working with them. Alright, let's see if this will work. Let's see if the searching will be done and then I can just go up there. See, augmentations, they help out a lot. So the arms, I needed this breakable wall, which I had before, I don't know what happened before, and also moving heavy objects. And then the next thing would be legs, which is two proxies. And then this one would be silent, which is one, but that one doesn't really matter for the current moment. Eyes. Highlight useful items within the confines of the small vision's area of effect. Effects are applied automatically when smart vision is active. Oh, cool. Place your stuff and shipment probes. And this gave me codes. Cool. Now for the proxy, I only need a little bit more, and then I think I'm going to either go for legs or arms. I don't know, because this will help me out a lot more. Alright, their searching should be done soon. So this episode has actually been doing pretty well. Nothing too crazy. I was about to say, I don't think they're actually searching for me. I think they're just searching for what had happened. And they don't know it's me. Crafting parts. Back up. More crafting parts and credit. This is good. This is good. This, I think, can lead me to the vent. And that got me a multi-tool. Ooh, this is really good. Yup, and here we are. The vent. Only issue is, of course, there's nothing up here.
You did see something, right?
Shh. Excuse me, please. They sent you to protect.
I don't know what evidence they want me to find. This is becoming harder and harder. I really wish my eyes would like show me it, but it can't.
Anything.
Keep it. Excuse me. No. Please. Did they send you to protect?
I need your help.
It's the harvester. Back from the dead.
You think
it was just a matter of time before they got her?
Before who got her?
She's that journalist. The one writing all those things about you know who.
You'll have to fill me in.
Radko Maximilian Petty? The local anti-Aug politician? That's Angela Gunn lying there. She's the one that's been writing about him. There was a threat of a scandal and everything. Coincidence?
Mitigate. It's important to follow the evidence in situations like this. You can't just accuse people left and right. Sounds like someone should go after this guy. Ask him some more questions.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Just, if you do that, please don't mention me. I don't want to end up like her.
What else can you tell me about Radko?
The guy's a sleazy piece of shit. That's all there is to it.
And you think he's capable of murder?
Absolutely.
Did you actually see anything?
I just got here, so I see what you see. A dead, augmented journalist.
Thanks.
So he couldn't tell me really, like, little. Right? But he said something. I think that panic involved people around here, which might be an issue. I'm so confused. What the heck? There's gotta be something here.
Please. Did they send you to protect me?
I don't see anything.
Best to be careful.
Stop, please!
What do you mean stop? There's nothing on here.
Excuse me, please. Did they send you to protect me?
I'm so confused.
On ahead, double back.
Nothing really on the walls.
Excuse me.
I don't know where to look. I really don't know. I'm stumped. Oh man. I don't know. Well, if I can't do this one, how about I do this other optional one? We'll travel to the other area, see what I can do there. Maybe they'll let me come back and check out the area again. But for right now, I kind of want to just continue on with something. And if necessary, because it's only an optional thing, I don't have to do it.
Hello.
It just would help out. But I mean, I'm so confused as to why it's not letting me find anything, you know? I feel like that's really weird. Alarm panel. Alright, so where does it want me to travel? This one. Alright, let's see what happens. Man, this episode is getting chock full with investigating and crime fighting and all that sort of stuff. And I augmented myself to be able to handle more augmentations at once, which is nice. I don't know. I'm trying to think of, like, what else could be in that spot? Where else could I go? I could have sworn the vent was something. It might still be something, though. Maybe I just have to check up there again. I don't know. This game is very an interesting one, though. It is a very good game. I like it a lot right now. I've been loving every mission. Man. I don't need my multi-tool out. Now we'll just walk this way. And then go from here.
Another one.
Alright, so now what? This way. What's this way? Oh, is this the police station? Examine his notes.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated. Access
There we go. What the heck? What, do the cops not like me checking out their information? Jeez. Jeez, I just got shot. Okay. Well, guess I can't do that. It's saying something about checking out his notes. Well, where are his notes if I can't go onto the computer? Well, at least I can do something.
Can't defend against that kind of team.
Hopefully. Jeez, I can't believe they just came in and shot me.
What a place.
Yeah, these are all just archive boxes, but it doesn't really tell me anything. Printer. Water cooler. There's nothing in here. Because all the archive boxes, it just says grab. I didn't want to go up here. Where am I? Oh, right here. Archive box, and a bowling ball. Printer. There's a lamp. What's this? Locked door. Three police officers.
I'm just going to keep walking.
I can go here. And then hit the computer. Now I'll try and do it this time.
They will understand we're doing it on their behalf.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Perfect.
Access granted.
I don't see the issue. There's no one here. Are they gonna come in? They are. Now what? Is my battery gonna go up? Boom, semi-auto. But we'll holster that. There's no need for it. I wonder if they're gonna search and then just go away.
Don't let him escape!
All clear on my side.
You're not finished yet.
They don't see me. Hopefully.
He ghosted us!
What? Is that one just getting up? Oh yeah, I did put him to sleep. They revived him.
Keep looking.
Nothing. They don't see me.
We're just trying to keep peace and order here.
Okay. And then once the searching's complete, I can access the computer and see what's on it. Hopefully. That was intense. Search completion, and now it's going to start from 0 to go to 100. But no one's in here, so. Well, they're kind of. They're at the door. That's weird. That was really weird. Just in case, I'll keep out my multi-tool. Put the trash can back. It's locked? What are you talking about? I just unlocked it though. I'm so confused.
Just keep moving.
Nemůžu se dočkat.
Body manipulation. Boom. now can I access the computer? I don't see an issue. I unlocked it. I hacked it. I don't know. This one has nothing on her. What about this one? Is this one also nothing? That's a robot, so I should wait till the robot goes away first. Nothing. Okay. Well, what's back here?
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
There we go.
Granted.
I have an AUG upgrade, which would be perfect. So I'll do that now. Well, first, I think the upgrade of jumping would be great, but the only issue is I need two, so maybe I'll do the arms first. So we'll do this one.
Find anything.
I don't see an issue. Interesting. I don't know why there's literally like no music or anything. Well, it's getting to close to the end of the episode, so let's see what happens. I mean, if it's just a smoke grenade, then it doesn't matter. But even if it's just a gas grenade, I have the upgrade of my lungs, so it won't affect me.
Keep quiet and search.
No one can still find me, which is strange.
Nothing here.
And then I'll wait if anything were to happen. The only reason I'm doing this, just in case.
No. No!
Alright, come on, get out the way. Please leave. Search completion. Update.
Okay. You're breathing. You're not finished yet.
I don't think I can take her out just by her being like that. I think they need to revive her in order for me to do that. Nothing. These cops have nothing on them. Weird. Alright, so now that it's unlocked, I can go through. And it's weird because I hacked it, but the computer I can't access. Like I said, strange. But now I should be able to go through. A lot of stuff back here. Combat rifle ammo, which will always be useful. There's a door to access. Nothing. Okay. What else is back here? Computers that I can't access. All this stuff. I'm trying to just find stuff. But for right now, doesn't look like there's anything here. Ooh. Found it. Grenade launcher EMP ammo. Interesting. A lot of stuff back here. Well, I think that's everything I need. So, what else is there? Story items. Harvester copycat victim 4. Name, Leone Wolf aka Jasmine, age 31. Well, I got information, which is useful. I fell down, which is not useful. My thing is, why can't I access this computer? Now I'm just gonna leave. Alright, so now, the only thing is, there's the main mission, which is meet Miller at the helipad. There's the side missions. Dig up dirt at the CEO's office, which is complicated right now. I don't even know if I can do it. Collect evidence and then talk to Johnny Gunn. So right now I'm going to go collect evidence and see if there's anything more I can do. Maybe. But I know that now that I have the information, I might be able to talk to like the detective or maybe the girl, and she can then say something. Or maybe I can just see what's up with them. Where am I going? The bottom one. Alright. This right here is where I'm going to be ending off the episode, though. So, we'll start and hopefully finish collecting evidence in the next episode. If you guys have enjoyed this episode, hit the like down below. I know I'm happy that I got the augment upgrade, basically, like being able to put it in the calibrator and all that. But it wasn't really that exciting. But, you know, it's worth it. It's definitely, definitely worth it. So now I can do all these fancy things. This game is lasting a while. I don't know how long this game is going to be, but it feels like I'm not even halfway through, to me, at least. I have no idea how many missions, how many side missions, but I do, if I get a side mission, I do want to complete them. I'd like to do all the optional stuff, you know, things here and there. With the last mission, though, in the last episode, mission, I believe it was like 10 or 9, I wish I did go to the bank, because, or maybe I was able to save his daughter, but for some reason I wasn't able to do either, and I failed all of it. Man. If I knew that she was that messed up and there was almost no way of getting her back, I would have went to the bank. Because it wasn't even like she was being controlled. It wasn't like she was being forced. She just was convinced that she was enlightened. Which is very strange. Man, so now I'm going to take my way, go over to the evidence center, talk to either the female or the detective, and hopefully they'll say something about that evidence that I just picked up. Which did not come pretty well. Which is okay. Come this way. Let's see what I can do. Whoa. Alright, never seen that before. It's a little weird.
Enjoying yourself, detective.
Let's talk about the case.
All right, so talk.
I think I might have some information on potential suspects.
Let me guess. It's the colonel with a lead pipe in the library.
The game clue.
Apparently the victim was mixed up in some kind of political scandal with a man named Radko Perry.
Hey. Not the first time a politician and a journalist didn't get along.
So you don't think...
Ooh, what am I doing? I'm supposed to end the episode.
Radko Perry,
oh my gosh. I literally just came over and started this.
I don't think so. Worst he can do to someone is get their car towed.
Good thing I don't have a car. Where can I find this guy?
After this, I'm ending it.
Campaign out of an old print shop not far from
Hurry
here.
Up.
You want to brighten up his day? Be my guest. But that's all you'll be doing by telling him his rival is dead.
Alright, so I'm just gonna leave this for now. I'm gonna end the episode, guys. If you liked it, hit the like button, comment down below. If you have any evidence that you can see, any sort of clue to this evidence, comment it, please. I would highly appreciate it. And of course, above all else, I will see you guys in the next episode. See ya!